Wu-Tang raised me, Death Cab changed me. You should go and ask Rihanna if the pen game's crazy.
This is Jon Bellion. I'm sure some of you know who he is. You might know his biggest hit, All Time Low, but I'm also sure a lot of you don't know who he is. There's quite a few videos going into his background about his musical prowess or deep diving into why he's underrated. But judging by my friend's reaction to my Sad Boy EP, music breakdowns probably aren't my thing. I really just want to break down why he's one of my favorite artists. Yes, I love the music, from what I heard 10 or however many years ago to what I hear now. But it's not just that The Human Condition is a personal classic for me with no skips, and no, you're not supposed to skip iRobot. Maybe it's just because his music is authentic and mixes different genres and subject matter. Maybe it's because he was the first concert I went to, and maybe it's because of the way I played Maz Joint for my dad when I first heard it. I mean, maybe it's the writing acumen, and I should point out songs like Memories or Graveyard or that Jonas Brothers album that he worked on. I don't know. I also don't know how many points I get in the fan club for knowing that he wrote Ghost the first time I heard it, but I know he wrote Ghost the first time I heard it. I look at it deeper. I feel like I see an artist who loves his craft. Maybe I'm reaching and stretching because I like the music, but any piece of content I see, it seems like this man would be a musician no matter what. If he made $0, if he was born in the 1700s and he played a fiddle on the roof, it just seems like he's living what he's supposed to do. Like his soul was meant to be here in these moments and making this art. And that's inspirational to me. I don't think we need to idolize people for making money or having whatever status, but when people find what they truly need, what they truly live for, I think that is the definition of
sun. Living prophecy is meek.